Round 4, lost ugly eyes for the fourth time, and this is a keep. Doesn't have the card that gives the deck the name, but it's still a fine hand. We're gonna play 1-1 on 1, which is not that exciting, but when you are following it up with a 4-3 on 2, reach trample also, that's a little bit better. DRS, I'm sorry my friend, we have just stupid creatures in our hand. Okay, we might be against the dreadful Mardu Green. Here, we could have cast just an Angerbeck and then level and cast the Avatar. But I prefer doing this because this is more damage. I don't know if I want to cast Mana Gorger either next turn, because if he's Mardu Green, he has so many shock effect between Kolaghan Command and Fiery Impulse. So maybe it's just better maybe it would have been just better to cast an Angerbeck for one this turn. Alright, Magic Land was lagging, but we see a Soulfire Grandmaster there, which is good enough to stop our Servant of the Scale, even if, unless we draw some kind of removal spell. So if we don't draw anything, maybe I prefer just casting a Angerbeck there. Play around removal and maybe just cast Mana Gorger into something later in the game. I can also cast Mana Gorger into Angerbeck for 0, but that doesn't seem appealing at all. We drew Abzan Falconer, which seems like a very good draw. Yeah, I'd like to play that. I would like to play that, attack for 5. I can also block the Soulfire back, but I very low expectation of the Abzan Falconer to survive. But yes, this is a good draw, because then, you know, we can play in curve and get it in with the Servant as well. Come on, opponent. Show up and fight. This is in. And 5 damage. Let's see what next. If it's just a Siege Rhino, then it's gonna be okay. It's a Crackling Doom though. Not really okay. What now? I can cast a couple of Angerbecks. They aren't great, but they do what they do. So yeah, let's just go with the Angerbecks. I know nothing about this deck, but seems like we can, you know, playing many, many small creatures, grow them a little bit at once, little by little, and eventually take the game. So here we keep attacking for 1, since it is flying. Also, the Angerbecks have flying. Oh, a concession? Why? Why do you consider this point? Maybe he has 3 lands? Yeah, that's a lot possible. Yeah, of course it's too early, but you know, leagues are quite fast. I would like to say the word Gideon in once again, which means that it's probably too good. I mean, it's maybe not good against the rally. It's maybe not good against I don't know. It was already it's a double white. It's gonna be a problem. We have 10 fetch land. It's 14 white source. That's not even that few. We're gonna board in evolutionarily because he has so many. Wolf Spell are gonna board in Valorous Stance because he has a Rhino and the 4/4 with Menace. And I think that's it. We are 64. We want to cut something. It's gonna be probably the Mana Gorger. It's expensive and I don't really wanna play it and pass the turn because he has so many removal spell for 2 damage. For 2 damage, even with our case in play. Opponent can just answer, playing a removal in response. Yeah, I like the rest of the deck. Onto the game 2 against Mardu Green. This is very, very underwhelming. Hold on, we don't have Ardent Scales. We don't even have a 1 drop. Nissa. Okay, or at least we have Gideon. Now, I'm gonna get a Canopy end of turn. Follow it up. Probably with an anger back because I don't want to just play Avatar Resolute 3-2. You have to play the least possible number of 2 toughness creature in this matchup, I think. No, of course, anger back it's not really a 2 toughness creature. I mean, it is, but opponent is never happy to just kill anger back. Okay, it doesn't have Soulfire Grandmaster. And what do we draw? Come on, KCK. All right, we draw 7 of the skills, which is not quite timely. Timely. Would have been good on throw 1. That's a bad thing of playing 1 drop that are quite weak because if they're drawn later in the game, then they're not that impressive. Alright, what do you want to do here? We have quite a little bit of option. Can just level Anger back and cast Avatar, but this way, if he has like double removal, double 2 damage card, it's gonna be bad. On the other hand, we can just play Abzan Falconer and attack. But I don't really like that play either. So I'd rather just do that. I'm gonna fetch up a Plains so I can cast Gideon with any land they draw and play Avatar and sorry, level the Anger back and play Avatar. This way I also have like bad cards in my hand, 7 of a scale, Handless One that I can use to. Oops, no. Should have done it. Well, maybe it's okay to do it right now. Opponent can't really kill it because I can Dramacus Command it. Alright, yet Fairy Impulse. And now I can't Kolaghan Command it. I hope he makes me discard rather than killing Topter. I have Disturbance of the. Alright, Radiant Flames. Once again, we got wiped by Radiant Flames. This one isn't really a card advantage because. Get Anger back. But we draw Nissa, which is quite powerful to be cast right now. Unfortunately, we didn't draw land. Gideon on an empty board is usually so good. Let's see if he has Goblin Art Dweller here. The famous combo Goblin Dark Dweller plus Converge cards, but he has also Fairy Impulse. Alright, he did have Goblin Dark Dwellers, killing my plant and passing the turn. Okay, we draw land. Which means that I can cast. Valor stance plus something. I don't want to cast Gideon and make a token, because if he just kills one of the token, Goblin Dark Dwellers has menace. So just killing one token, he can kill my Gideon. So I'd rather just cast maybe Endless 1-2-2 and a plant. On the other end, yeah. No, I think I have to cast Valorous Stance here. I have to. So even if this Endless One seems very, very weak, I think it's needed. Maybe I just Valorous Stance it right now, so that if he... You never know, he might have a Valorous Stance on his own. We know that this, that we are doing this, that we are playing Valorous Stance on his Dark Dwellers. So why not just doing it now? Destroy target creature. And pass. We probably want 4 Valorous Stance overall, because cards like Siege Rhino and the Goblin Dark Dwellers are quite difficult to deal with, I would say. Chandra, on the other end, is quite difficult to deal with as well. If he wants to minus 2 here, I'm fine. If he wants to plus 1 it, I don't really know. It's a tough call. Let's see. Let's see what you decide. Because if I minus 1 Nissa and a minus 1 Gideon, then I can kill Chandra if he plus 1. But if he plus 1 Chandra, then he probably wants to attack Nissa. Alright, chose to plus 1 Chandra. And he chose to attack who? Chose to attack Nissa, of course. If I block with a plant, just with a plant. Yeah, like this. Like this better. Block with the plant. And then what? I can play Absent Falconer and the Servant of the Scale and put a token on everyone. Attack Chandra down to 2. So that the minus 2 doesn't do anything. I mean, just kills the Servant. Doesn't kill Endless One and the Absent Falconer. And the Radiant Flames kills... Doesn't kill the Absent Falconer. Yeah. I think I like this play. I like this play. Yeah. Dromica's command doesn't change anything, in my opinion. Let's sacrifice our Planeswalker and attack Chandra down to 2. Now he has to have like Languish would be very bad. Crackling Doom. Alright, I'll sacrifice the Endless One. What's that? And I believe this is a subject to since I read in the chat. You know, images arrives later here. Okay, we sacrifice Servant of the Scale, and I believe we put 2 tokens on the Falconer. Falconer is now quite large. Chandra, I think, is gonna do the zero ability. He just wanted to empty his hand before doing that. We are in excellent shape now. We are going to kill the Chandra, playing Gideon empty board. And Dev also. Dromok is coming to fight his eventual, like, Siege Rhino or like whatever drew. Discard a Siege Rhino. To tap a white source. Thanks, Chandra. Hope it didn't draw murderous cut there. Okay, it didn't. Right, Kolaghan Command. Deal us 2 damage and he returns Goblin Dark Dwellers. Probably wants to. He has a land in hand, so he's going to replay Dark Dwellers and replay Kolaghan Command to kill the Gideon and then with Siege Rhino in his hand. But we. Oh no, he has just Roast. That's weird. Could that take back Siege Rhino? Whatever. We are just playing Avatar. We are. Plusing 1 Gideon. And we are getting in for 10 damage. Next turn is probably he probably wants to do Dark Dwellers Roast. But we have the Dromoka's command up to prevent the damage and kill the Dark Dwellers. Which is gonna be game, I think. Crackling Doom, sure. Yeah, I forgot about the Crackling Doom. I guess it's okay. Cast it, and then we. What do we want to do? We want to put a token on target creature. It's gonna be the Avatar, and the Falconer fights with the Dark Dwellers. This one we can also sacrifice. I think we still want to sacrifice the Abzan Falconer so that if he draw. Fiery Impulse. He can't kill our Falconer. Like, if we sacrifice the Avatar now. Okay. We won the match. Alright, on to the last match of the league.